Hey guys, welcome to my channel. So today I have Murka here with me again. Murka is my 14-year-old Russian blue, and I have two videos with her already. You guys can check those out. They'll like pop up at the end of this video. Yeah, one of them was a day in the life of my cat. The other one was, I don't know, something about Russian blues. Anyways, ow. I got a lot of questions on those videos about her and like about Russian blues. So today we're doing a Q&A. I'm gonna answer some of those questions. Just a disclaimer before we get started, I'm not a cat expert of any sort. I'm not an expert on Russian blues. I'm gonna be speaking purely based off of personal experience with her. Okay, let's just readjust here. Okay, here we go. So the first questions came as a set of questions. Number one, did you get her as a kitten? Yes, we did get her as a kitten. I was 4 years old when we got her. I got her as a birthday gift, kind of. But I don't remember how old she was. She was a kitten. We went and we got her. We picked her out from the litter. Well, actually, she kind of picked us because she kind of just like came crawling out of there. And yeah, so we've had her for a very long time. Got her as a kitten. That's probably why she's adjusted so well to our house. Number two, was she easy to train? Yes, the simple answer is yes. It may have been because we got her as a kitten and because we got her from like a pretty good breeder. I don't know what factors affect trainability, but she learned to use the litter box basically right away. She's never had any accidents really around the house. And yeah, number three, is she always peaceful? Basically like 99.8% of the time, she is very peaceful. As you can see here, she's like not really suffering too bad by being in this video. She's just kind of chilling. I would say she's always peaceful. There have only been a handful of instances throughout her whole life when she has gotten a little angry or something. But all those times she did get angry, they were definitely justified. So yes, she is a very peaceful cat. Great family cat. Number four, has she ever hurt you? Maybe once or twice in my whole life, but I don't think she did it intentionally because, say, you're playing with her, and especially when they're kittens, they're a little more clumsy, I'd say, and kind of just hyperactive. And I just remember one time, like, the toy went on my foot or something, and she jumped to get the toy and kind of scratched my foot a little bit, but she's never intentionally hurt me. So again, she's a very peaceful family cat, doesn't get angry very much, which is amazing because I hear some cats get really angry often. Alrighty, next question. Does Murka scratch your furniture? We've been dying to get a Russian blue but are worried about our furniture. The answer is yes. They do scratch furniture quite a bit. She doesn't anymore because she's older and less agile. But when she was growing up, she was scratching all the furniture. But there are solutions to that, even though they don't work very well. Like, we got the little sticker that you put on the couch so that they don't scratch it, but they kind of do. So, I don't know. It helps if you don't have leather furniture because that's her personal favorite. But yeah, she doesn't scratch anymore. She did a lot when she was a kitten. You ready to go? I'll take that as a no. Okay. She's huge. Oh, also, there was a comment in my past video that said that she's getting fat. And yes, we are aware she is getting slightly overweight. She still looks pretty thin, but Russian blues are pretty sensitive about weight because naturally she's been skinny her whole life. But recently she did gain a little bit of weight, so we're really trying to fix her diet and have it be more controlled, giving her wet food instead. So we're working on it. Thank you for your concern. Next question. How would you describe the grooming situation? Is she a big shedder? Do you have to use a specific comb? She doesn't shed too much. Obviously, when you hold her like this, she'll have hair left over. Are you ready to go? Okay. She's ready to go. Give me a second. Alrighty, I don't know where she's gonna go next. Anyways, so shedding, grooming. She kind of sheds, like after you hold her, you do have fur all over you, but I think that's normal for most cats. The grooming situation is pretty easy though. She doesn't shed as much as other cats. I know that because they are considered to be a hypoallergenic breed, so the shedding is definitely less than other cats. Do I have to use a specific comb? Not really. We just use, I don't have it with me right now, but it's like the soft ones. I don't know, maybe I'll insert a picture or something if I remember. But we've also used like the plastic bristle ones. I don't know. She just likes anything she can rub her head up against, so I don't think that really matters, but I'm not an expert, so yeah, we'll just leave it at that. All right, so finally, I'm not gonna read out a specific question for this because I did get a handful of questions asking about allergies, because I mentioned in one of my past videos that I do get allergic reactions to her, which brought up a bit of confusion because Russian Blues are known to be hypoallergenic cats. However, even if a cat or a dog is hypoallergenic, that does not mean that you won't have a reaction to them. And yeah, so a lot of people won't have allergies to her because she's hypoallergenic, but I don't know, maybe I have worse allergies than normal, because whenever I hold her, or if she like lays on my bed or something, then I can't breathe afterwards very well. It's not too bad. I definitely have worse allergy with other cats, so it's definitely not as bad with her, but my mom also has allergies on her, and we can't really hold her without like washing our hands right after or anything. And, well, okay, part of this question, how do you cope with your allergies living with her? I never had allergies to her when I was a child. They kind of developed, but the way I cope with it is anytime I pet her, I just go and wash my hands afterwards, probably about like up to here, because if I ever do get a reaction, it's kind of like a bit bubbly right here, and then it's just really itchy. And if she's ever near my face, I just make sure to wash my face as well, because I also get the little bubble allergy bubbles here. Oh yeah, my nose is getting a little bit itchy right now because I don't usually hold her like on me right up next to my face. But for the sake of this video, I'll just change my sweater and wash my face and hands after this. But another thing I do is I don't let her sleep on my bed or spend too much time in my room, because she used to sleep on my bed a few years ago and I just could not breathe every night because there was like a thin layer of fur there. So really what I'd recommend, if you think you have allergies to cats and you're looking for a hypoallergenic breed like the Russian Blue, I highly recommend just finding a Russian Blue and like stick your face in their fur to see what kind of reaction you have. Rub like the sensitive areas of your skin on the fur so you can see if you would get a reaction. But if your allergies aren't too bad, it is possible to live with them. In my case, for example, you're just gonna have a few limitations in terms of petting and where they can go so that you can breathe at night. Okay, as you can see, she's she was trying to get on my bed. No, oh my god, bruh. Okay, so I almost forgot to mention, but another thing I do to cope with allergies is I use a lint roller on clothes anytime I hold her, on a bed if she ever does manage to get on it. So yeah, this just collects the fur really nicely and reduces allergic reactions, just like when you're walking around the house. Also, this one is just kind of logic. If you vacuum the floor more often, there will be less fur in your house, so less allergies. I'm grabbing her for the outro so you guys can see her a bit more. So yeah, when she rubs her face on mine like that, I usually get allergies afterwards, but don't worry, I'll wash everything after this. If you liked this video, don't forget to leave a thumbs up, comment down below, whatever you want, I don't know, stories, suggestions, whatever comes to mind. And subscribe and hit the notification bell for more content if you're not subscribed already. Also, as I already mentioned, don't forget to check out the other two videos I have with her on my channel if you liked this one and if you want to see more of her. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!